Yo, what's going on? It's your boy Miles Cunningham with another reaction, and here we go. Wait, but before we go, check out my t-shirt. I don't sleep on the couch, bitch. All right. If you guys want your t-shirts, man, go to thebadboystyle.com. Thebadboystyle.com. One more time. I don't sleep on the couch. Yes, sir. All right. Make sure y'all go get your t-shirts, man. We got a lot of different designs. Thebadboystyle.com. All right. Let's get into this reaction.
I'm serious. Every womanizer, every player, every guy juggling three broads at the same time is only doing so out of fear. Fear of being crushed by a woman. Because one day, back in the day, they weren't a player. They liked one girl.
And they gave it up.
And they gave it up to her. That's right. They gave it up to her because they're little romantics back then. And they gave it up to the girl they love. And what happened? They got rocked, or they got crushed, or they got destroyed, they got cheated on, or laughed at, or something. And when they're finished picking up the little pieces of what was once their heart, you know what they said? They all, every single one of them, made a vow.
Never to give it up again.
That's right, never to give it up again. But now we're talking about the real bastards here, the guys that break hearts occupationally. Because believe it or not, originally those cats were the most beautiful and the most romantic of all. And you know what happened? They're the ones that got hurt worst of all.
All right, listen, man. Listen. I understand what he's saying. I don't disagree with what he's saying at all. I don't disagree with what he's saying. But see, rhetoric like this, it's that victim shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, get some. Once, see, here's the thing with game. Here's the thing with understanding, you know, male-female dynamics and understanding your masculine identity. Once you get into that world where you have an understanding of who you are, a lot of these things don't, like, this perspective can be considered weak. You understand? Because you're not doing things because you're scared of a woman crushing you. You're doing things because you want to. But let me play it back and we could break it all the way down.
I'm serious. Every womanizer, every player, every guy juggling three broads at the same time is only doing so out of fear. Fear of being crushed by a woman.
You see, that's the part I don't like. If I'm juggling three women, I'm doing it because I want to, not because I'm afraid of being crushed by anyone. If I'm juggling three women, I can lose all three and still be just fine, because I know that no matter what I got in this world, if I lose it, I still got me. Because guess what? It was me that got them in the first place. So if I still got me after I lose all of the shit, then that means I could get it again because I got me still. You understand? So when I hear stuff like this, it's like, I get what you're saying. Yes, we all started from that place where we had a certain level of romance and simping. And, you know, we thought women were sugar, spice and everything nice because all of the stuff we've been brainwashed. But at this point, it's like at some point, man, you got to learn game. You got to understand your masculine identity. You got to get on the masculineidentitymembership.com. Huh? You got to stop playing the victim at some point, and you got to learn the lessons that you need to learn you're not at this level where you're still juggling three women because you're afraid of something. Juggle three women because you want to. You understand? Like, here's the thing that I talk about from time to time. We got decision A and we got decision B. A lot of people choose one or the other, right? So let's just say they choose A. So they go with option A. But here's the thing. They don't go with option A because they really like option A. They go with option A because they're deathly afraid of option B. And what I'm trying to explain to you is that when you understand who you are as a person, you will be able to choose A or B, not because you're afraid of the latter, but because you actually want to. Because you're making a decision based on who you are naturally. That's the point you're trying to get to. You're not trying to, nobody out here should be juggling three women because they're afraid of losing women. You should be juggling three women because all of them are nice. They are compatible with you. The sex is fun. You get along. You have a good time. And it makes your life, it enriches your life. It complements your life. That's why you should be doing it. Not because you're afraid of anything.
One day, back in the day, they weren't a player. They liked one girl.
And they gave it up.
And they gave it.
You see, and this type of rhetoric also implies that liking one girl and being with only one girl is the only way it should be. And that's, we all know that that's not true. We all know that's not true. Okay. Because back in the day, they liked one girl. And as if that was the perfect way to be. Like, nah, there's nothing perfect, but there's nothing good or bad about it. It's just, did you like one girl because you only liked one girl, or did you like one girl because that's what you were told, because that's what you were programmed to believe? You see what I'm saying? See, there are lessons that come from a book, and then there are life lessons, right? So you can follow society, you can follow traditions, and you can read it in a book somewhere, right? But guess what? Life is still going to show you and teach you lessons that have nothing to do with what your parents told you, have nothing to do with what the schools taught you, and have nothing to do with what was written in a book somewhere. It's going to teach you what you need to know based on the experience of your life, which will help you mold your masculine identity.
Up to her. That's right. They gave it up to her because they were romantics back then, and they gave it up to the girl they love. And what happened? They got rocked, or they got crushed, or they got destroyed. They got.
And you see, let me explain something to you. He's saying it as if it was a bad thing. I'm telling you here and now, getting your heart broken is your diploma. You understand? It's your rite to passage. Like, let me tell you, you shouldn't even have the right to have a girlfriend until you have gone through some bullshit with females. Simply so you can get the understanding, get the lesson. Because you want to, see, here's the thing. You want to deal with the emotions of frustration before you get to the relationship. Because you don't want to get into what you consider to be a good relationship, and then something happens to disappoint or frustrate you, and then the whole relationship goes to shit. You want to have all of those lessons already built in. So when you get into the relationship and something goes wrong, you know how to handle it to keep the relationship going, as a man should. You see what I'm saying? So videos like this, yes, I understand what he's saying. I get it. Trust me. I'm not disavowing what he's saying. Yes, we were all back in the day. We were all, you know, brainwashed. Women are sugar and spice and everything nice, and they should be treated like delicate flowers. And then they turn around and break our hearts. Yes, I get it. We all know the story. We've all been through it. The bottom line is, what did you learn? Did you learn how to become a man that knows how to run his game tight and design his masculine identity, and then use that masculine identity to design the relationships he wants and how he wants it? Or did you just go through that experience just to continue to be a fucking victim, even in your adulthood? That's the question.
Cheated on or laughed at or something, and when they're finished,
you see Cuba Gooden is shaking his head like, this nigga over here playing that victim role, I can't take it.
Picking up the little pieces of what was once their heart, you know what they said? They all, every single one of them, made a vow
never to give it up again.
That's right, never to give it up again. But now we're talking about the real bastards here, the guys that,
you see, here's the thing. You make a vow never to give it up again, not because you're afraid of a woman breaking your heart again. You make a vow never to give it up again because you get to a point of understanding that, and you understand how to love. You understand that women and men are different, therefore we love differently. You understand that love has nothing to do with emotions necessarily. Love has a lot more to do with leadership. Love, as far as a man goes in a relationship, love has a lot to do with leadership, consistency, strength, provision, service, and your identity, your masculine identity, letting that woman know who you are, and then choosing to be consistent and to consistently show that woman what a life with you means on a consistent basis, day to day, week by week, month to month, year by year. You understand? That's how a man actually loves. He loves through service, leadership, confidence, and knowledge to lead his family in a certain direction. So if you're leading a woman in a certain direction and then she's like, oh, well, I don't know about this, fire her. There's no heartbreak. You fire her. You get what I'm saying? You just let her go. Do what she do. You understand? Now if you happen to get married and then it's a whole shit show and they take half your stuff, then so be it. Again, you're still learning another lesson. However, The question is, before you got married, did she actually earn the position of being your wife? Before you started having sex with her raw, did she actually earn the position of being the mother of your children? All of that type of stuff has to do with game. Now, I'm not saying that game is 100% foolproof, but what I'm saying is, with certain levels of game, you at least can choose to put a woman in a position in your life that actually respects you. So you at least have a fighting chance that she won't be as vindictive during the divorce, let's just say. You at least have a fighting chance that if you have to divorce, it'll be an amicable divorce and you can still co-parent in a healthy way. And the reason why is because she respects you, because you created a structure. Now, if the relationship just didn't work because y'all grew apart, fine, but the respect is there. And that's the only reason why you would have married her in the first place, because the respect was there. But see, all these type of things come with game. All these type of things come with understanding your masculine identity, knowing who you are, and then knowing how to move when it comes to designing your relationships. And if you don't, and if you continue to play the victim, it's going to be very hard for you to understand these principles so you can design the type of relationships you really want.
Break hearts occupationally, because believe it or not, originally those cats were the most beautiful and the most romantic of all. And you know what happened?
You see, beautiful and romantic. What's that? I don't know what that is. I don't know what that is. Now, can I design an experience that I like and bring my woman along for the ride, and she enjoys herself and benefits from a dynamic experience with her man? Yes. Am I being romantic? Not so much. Can my woman feel romance from what I'm doing? Yes. But is my purpose in bringing her out and having a good time to romance her necessarily? No, because all of it has to do with my masculine identity, my leadership, the confidence that I have in myself, the fact that I already like going to these type of places and I bring her along and she enjoys herself thoroughly. Why? Because we are compatible. You see, there's a lot of little nuances that comes with understanding game and understanding relationships that a lot of guys, they don't want to get because they're stuck on a rhetoric like this. They're still just, you see, look at the look of he's a grown ass man, still has a look of frustration on his face when talking about women. All right, so let's finish up.
They're the ones that got hurt worst of all.
Listen, guys, we can't play the victim anymore. Okay. We can't play the victim anymore. In this life, it's not about what happens. It's about how you respond, and how you respond is based on who you are. So that's why you have to learn how to build your masculine identity. Go to masculineidentitymembership.com. It's your boy Miles Cunningham. Hope you're having a great day. And always remember, the truth is inside you. Peace.